Wake up, everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more back thinking, time for thinking again. World has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Wake up all teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming, world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best.
We're excited to have with us the VIPs of the Daphne Stanley and Ms. Linda Gregory.
The world won't get no better. We gotta change it now, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair. They don't have so very long before their judgment day. Won't you make them happy before they pass away? Wake up all the builders, time to build a new land.
Even our future being bloody until it becomes a blur. Others arguing on how to inoffensively use a slur.
George Washington, when you won the revolution, how many of your soldiers did you send from the battlefield back to the
cause? Once upon a time in Tulsa, there was a community called Greenwood. Its residents descended from Black Indians, formerly enslaved.
Young people, get your song in your heart. I almost get a note for you. But get something other than yourself to guide you. The hill
learns to breathe fresh air.
Hello, Garland ISD family. Thank you for joining us tonight here, Facebook Live via Zoom for Better Together. My name is Jonathan. I'm the coordinator for family and community engagement here in Garland ISD. And tonight we have some really special guests that are going to share information that highlights our African American History Month initiatives and how we truly are better together. I have some questions prepared for tonight, but we'll also be looking at the chat to get some questions for our guests. So please comment on the video, ask any questions that you have. Our team is monitoring the chat and they'll be answering some of the questions and selecting some for our guests. As always, please remember to share this video. And for us, would you please type your name and your role? That way we can see who is viewing and who's participating with us tonight and which campuses you're from. Also, if you know someone that speaks Spanish or Vietnamese, and we do captions in other languages, so please feel free to share this with all your groups. And publicaremos videos con subtítulos en español y vietnamita de nuestras presentaciones después de cada evento. And this video will be uploaded on YouTube in the next day or two, and we'll be sharing that out, and you can share that with your friends. So to start, if we could just get our amazing panel members to introduce yourself and tell us how you serve families in Garland ISD.
Hi, good evening, everyone. My name is Shania Smith, and I am the Garland Area Alliance of Black School Educators President. As well as I work in Garland ISD, I've been here for the last 14 years, and I'm excited to be here and share everything with you guys tonight. So thanks for having me.
Glad you're here.
Good evening. My name is Mrs. Crystal Jones Lacey, and I am an English 4 teacher here at North Garland High School. This is my first year here in Garland ISD, so I'm super excited to be here. I'm also the sponsor of the African and Black Student Union.
All right. Thank you.
Hi, and thank you. I am Dr. Angie Davis, and I work for Renaissance Learning. And we have been in partners with Garland ISD with the Literacy for Life project. And I am actually coming to you live from New York City. I feel like it's Saturday Night Live. From my hotel, I'm at a conference here where I have learned such amazing things about English language learners, as well as social justice and equity, and so much that I cannot wait to bring back to this amazing Garland team and share. So I'm looking forward to the panel this evening.
We're looking forward to find out what you learned and how it's going to help our families. Thank you. So tell us about the African American History Month initiatives that you're a part of or that you know of that are going on this month across our district.
That's a great question, Jonathan. There's so many intricate things going on for African American History Month. As president of GAPC, Garland Area Alliance of Black School Educators, we wanted to make it more personalized. And so we sent out correspondence to anyone who promotes any form of Black history event, shirt, paraphernalia, quotes, whatever inspires you to tag us, hashtag GAPC is Black History on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, because we wanted to make it personal and, you know, connect with the community as well as the school district that GAPC is an integral part of Black history. Our Texas Alliance of Black School Educators Conference is this weekend. It starts tomorrow. And it's just such a blessing to be a part of not only a local organization that focuses on student achievement with an emphasis on African-American students, but also to be a part of a state and national level organization that does the same thing. And so, as we know, sometimes our Black and Brown students sometimes lose their voice and their families might not have that. And so just to be an advocate of that, for that in Garland ISD and have the support of not only Dr. Lopez, but awesome departments as FACE, I think that is just so amazing, truly, truly. So those are the ones that I am aware of off the top of my head. Oh, wait, there's one more next week. The FACE department is putting on a African American Black History Month program. It is going to be great, and it's focused on the arts. And so we are really, really thankful for the invitation to be a part of that as well.
All right. I have a quick question. Now, GABC is full of this amazing group of really strong educators and administrators, right? A wealth of expertise, pedagogy, right? Instruction, yeah. Curriculum. And so if there's a teacher or an administrator that said, you know, we would like to kind of beef up our celebration next year, maybe even this year, is your organization a resource for them where, you know, it can be hit and miss sometimes at a campus. One person's really comfortable. One person has a lot of info and another teacher at a different grade level is maybe a newer teacher and just doesn't have that wealth of experience. Are y'all that resource?
Absolutely. We would be 100% able to help and support that. The great thing about GAPC and being so supportive in a district like Garland ISD is that we are able to share our information throughout the district. And we have teachers, we have paraprofessionals, administrators, community leaders all throughout Garland. And with that span of community from pre-K all the way to the third floor at Harris Hill, we could build a team for support no matter what campus that, you know, that whatever campus, no matter what campus needed support. There are great high schools doing great things, Lakeview, Rowlett, Sachse, all coming together and doing their own highlight of Black History Month. And so I think we just need to keep the momentum going and for it to get bigger and stronger and, you know, just help people to connect more to it during this month.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. Thank you. Who's next?
So I can talk a little bit about what we're doing at North Garland. And if you guys see me kind of rolling around, my lights will go out if it doesn't detect that I'm moving. So last night we had our African-American read-in. This was our third annual African-American read-in. And the first one 2 years ago, I was actually able to attend, not as a teacher, but just as a patron. And both of my kids read. So I knew that it was a really cool event. We had some good turnout that year. So when we decided to do it again this year, I was super excited about it because now was my turn. I think my husband was over it the first time they did it. And so the pressure was on and I really had to, like, you know, knock it up a little bit. So when I went home, I could say, yeah, that was me this time. So we had a phenomenal event. And just to give you a little bit of history about the African-American read-in, it was started in 1990 by the National Council of Teachers of English. And it was created to make literature a significant part of Black History Month. And so the read-in allows really not just students, teachers, but also the community to choose an excerpt from a novel, a poem, and even original works that they've written by African-American writers, and then bring it into the read-in and share with everyone. And so that's what we did. We had a phenomenal event. And just to kind of add a little more interest to it, we had some different acts. Our jazz band, our newly formed jazz band, came out and they were amazing. Our step team, Raider Heat, performed. We had the choir. It was just awesome. It was a phenomenal event. Lots of guests. We had local food trucks come in also. So we had a great event. And that was just one of the things that we've done here on campus. We start each morning in February with our moment in Black history, just to keep it on our students' mind and so that they're learning daily. We actually offer African-American studies to our students at North Garland, which is so awesome. Coming from Dallas, that's not something that we had. And so to see it here in place and up and running, it has just been great. And my daughter even takes the class. So that's another thing, that our students are able to get that rich history, not just in February, but all year long. Also throughout the district, as you mentioned, as y'all mentioned before, they're also doing their own different Black history programs. I know that we were invited to a program at Rowlett High School. They're doing some type of showcase or a talent exposition. So I know that lots of schools are doing different things and getting everyone involved. And here at North, I can tell you, it's been awesome. Our read-in was great. And I know that it's successful when the kids stop you and say, hey, Miss Lacey, we had a great time, or we really enjoyed it. Because the adults, you know, they'll kind of smooth it over. They want to be nice. They don't want to hurt your feelings. But kids will tell you the truth most of the time. So when they told me they had a good time, I was like, okay, we were successful.
So if you can learn and have fun all while you're at school, it was a good day.
It was right? A good day. It was a great day.
And you know what I love, what you're describing, right? Is it's very easy to get through African-American History Month. And you've glossed, you know, you've hit Rosa Parks, Martin Luther King, and Jackie Robinson.
Right.
Right. And you're like, yeah, we've talked about it. And bringing in all these different, you're introducing students to new artists, new writers, right? You're fleshing out the full scope of culture and history, because our history started, your history started, everyone's history started long before 1960s, right? Long before 1776, right? And so to be able to pull all this in and make it part of our history. And so that, because my daughters, you know, they're in GISD, and the first year they were in GISD, they came home talking about Rosa Parks and Martin Luther King. And I'm like, you know, well, now wait a minute, right? So thank you for what you're doing. right? And I think it's something that every school could do, right? There's elementary.
Of course. Of course, and it can start small and progress bigger like we did, but it was really great, and you would be amazed with what the students come up with, even their original work, so much passion in talking about their experiences and things like that. It was just phenomenal, and like you said, introducing everyone to new authors and new figures in Black history that they haven't heard of, you know, throughout the years. So it was just a phenomenal event and definitely doable for all schools on all levels.
Now, are you a resource? If someone at another school wanted to do something like this next year, should they be reaching out to you?
Definitely. I don't know if I'm a pro. I might call myself a pro after this event. No. But they could definitely reach out to me. We were able to put it together really with the help and assistance of everyone. And I'll probably talk about that later. But I'm definitely a resource. And what I learned here being new too is when I asked, everyone was a resource. Everyone wanted to help. So I'm definitely a resource. We had a phenomenal event, and I'd be happy to help someone else, you know, have one also on their campus.
All right. And Ms. Davis?
Yeah, and I loved the video, Crystal, so thank you so much for sharing that. It really portrayed the amazing work going on in Garland ISD. I always say that Garland is the best kept secret. I have students or children that live, and we live in North Texas, that attend a nearby district, and I've always said you guys are the best kept secret, and that's one of the many reasons why. We are hosting our third annual as well digital read-in, and we'll put a link to the digital read-in on the chat for you guys. And what we do with this is we're going to do it every single year, and we're highlighting amazing authors and really diverse titles and all of the amazing legacy that many of the people and all of the authors have, you know, laid for us. And there's a huge selection of diverse titles. We also honor Hispanic heritage as well as Asian heritage in May, because I feel like it's really important that we represent the entire community. And so with this digital read-in, it's also for the community. And Mayan is free, not only for the students, but it's free for the entire community of Garland ISD. So you have an opportunity on the website to create your own account. And then we're also tweeting out books on a daily basis that highlight some of the amazing titles and digital library within our digital library of Mayan. So we're really excited to have our third year. And at the end of the month, and we'll be celebrating all the students that read over 500 minutes. And ultimately, the goal is to build that love of literacy, regardless of where you live, regardless of color, of all of those things. Just honestly, we want all children to love reading. And that's kind of the premise behind all of the Mayan and the Literacy for Life work that we've been doing. So I'm really excited to honor those students at the end of the month and the schools, too, that just really continue to have that commitment to literacy.
Well, we really appreciate your partnership at Mayan, and we've seen the titles grow. The library has gotten bigger.
Absolutely.
And your responsiveness to learning about our students and what motivates them and what encourages them. And we've seen some amazing things at some schools, haven't we? Just the number of minutes read, the number of books read, and the children, their comments about what they're learning and what they're loving, right? I know that it's definitely grown, hasn't it?
Absolutely. And just to brag really quick on you guys, Garland's read almost 6 million minutes this year. And the community is, you know, we're trying to expand that community aspect. We're right around just under 1 million minutes read by the Garland community. So that's a huge win for everybody in the entire area. So 6 million minutes is a lot. And I mean, just imagine all the amazing people and the amazing stories the students have had exposure to, the vocabulary, all those wonderful things. So it's just been an amazing opportunity for sure.
All right. Tell us how your team celebrates and honors our diverse community all year. We've talked about this month, right? But what about all year?
I love that question. And I kind of want to piggyback on what Dr. Davis said. She said all the vocabulary. And so in my current position, I do compliance and instructional support for students who are new to the country and or who are in the ESL program at the secondary level. So ensuring that those students have their accommodations for testing, ensuring that they are on the right graduation plan, that their foreign credits align with state requirements and filling in the gaps. And vocabulary equals voice equals advocacy. And when I think about what we do in not only my role as GAPSE president, but also as an LPAC lead for the district, I service two campuses. That for me is advocacy all year long. And even what, no matter what my future aspirations are or what I've done in the past, I know that God has me in this role, in this realm, at this stage for a reason. And I have always, my mom said, I was always passionate about what was right and she never had to worry about me. But I know that that has transcended into just being an advocate for all students, and especially our Black and Brown students who may sometimes lose their voice. And I think as a community, we need to continue to empower our parents and to get more involved and to recognize that when you increase your vocabulary, your knowledge, what you know, what's going on, then you also increase your voice, which leads to advocacy. And that's year long and that's lifelong.
I will piggyback off of that question. For North Garland, it is so important that we celebrate culture here. This is the most diverse campus I have ever been to, and I am just in love with it. We have so much going on, so many different organizations, and I know through ABSU, which is the African Black Student Union, we help celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month. In September. So we put up a 3D mural with the words. It had a girl, it had all the Hispanic authors and book covers attached to it. And it was totally 3D. The kids could come by and touch it. And it said, "My voice is my power," because we really believe that. I strongly believe that these students have voices and that's their power. So we definitely want to cultivate that. In addition to that, I mentioned before, we have the African American studies and we also have Hispanic studies on on campus where the students can take that year round. And you'd be amazed when you walk into the classroom, you see all colors. It's not just Hispanics in Hispanic studies or just African Americans in African American studies. It's, you know, a rainbow of colors. And I think that is so awesome. I've never seen anything like it until I got here and I'm just in love with it. Along with that, we have our anti-racism club here on campus. This is something that I think they started a couple years ago and they were doing kind of virtually. And now we're able to meet somewhat in person, which has been really cool. But that group is centered around really educating students, educating the community, educating teachers on social biases and prejudices that they might not know that they have. It also provides students a safe place where they feel like their voice can be heard. So we have safe spaces and safe teachers where if a student has an issue and they're not comfortable discussing it with someone, they can go to that teacher, they can go to that classroom, and they know that their voice is going to be heard and they have an advocate. So I think that that's really awesome. And that's what we do here at North Garland.
All right.
And that is so awesome. Like, I can't wait to come visit you guys because I want to come see and observe the class. It sounds so amazing. One of the things that as a company that we do is the goal and the mission of our company is to accelerate learning for all. And so with that being said, you know, we've had a huge push this year to make sure that our books are diverse and that all of our products are truly equitable and that it's accessible. And so that's why Mayan has been such a big thing for the area. I talked my son's school into getting it because he's in a very diverse school. And I'm like, you guys have to have this. You know, it's an amazing product. And then we also have Maya News, which also the community has access to as well. And it gives students a voice. And the news is vetted by child psychologists. So it is telling, you know, the stories that are going on from a different lens, with a social and emotional lens, which I think is so incredibly important right now. I've seen it in my own children, just the change and their social and emotional, you know, thoughts and beliefs as we've gone through these last few years. And, you know, I'm just very excited to be a partner in this, because I think Garland is truly in the forefront of a lot of this work. And I have the opportunity to work with districts across all of North Texas and the nation. And you guys are truly in the forefront of this work. And we're happy to be there with you and honor all the cultures. And like I said, we have the Asian American studies and all of that big contest coming up in May, where we can honor all of those families. We're going to be adding Vietnamese titles, which is something that we've really advocated for, and just continuously growing this amazing library to support all students.
All right. Thank you. Let's talk about values. One of the district's values, right? Or what we say is that we value and celebrate all cultures. So we're in better together, right? How does celebrating our diverse community foster the idea that we are truly better together?
When I first moved to Garland, I was teaching in, well, before I moved, I was teaching in Nacogdoches. Good old Nacogdoches. I went to SFA. I'm from a very small town called Alto. Most people don't know where that is. 1,200 people in the town. So my first job here was at Raleigh High School, and there were 3,000 students. So it was a bit overwhelming. But I'll never forget when I went to that job fair and Galen Garrison said, "Have you thought about Garland?" And I was like, "Where's Garland? You know, I know Dallas, I know Plano, Houston, where's Garland?" And he was like, "It's a little suburb." And so when I came in 2008, I hated it. I hated it. I felt like it was too big. I was like, what did I do? You know, I was just 26 years old. But I can truly say, people ask me, why have I never left? I can truly say after 14 years, I've never left because it truly is a family. It truly is a community. There are always going to be ups and downs, no matter the journey and path that you are on. But I'm a living witness of the support that Garland has provided me, as well as my colleagues, as well as my family. My family still can't believe that I'm always so busy, but there's always something to do with Garland ISD. There's always some work to be done. There's always some event to go and support, but we don't do this because we get extra money. We do this because we want to do this. We do this because we truly want to help the students of Garland ISD as well as the families. It is very, very connected. And I think Ms. Lacey has continuously talked about that today, just based on her first year here. A more specific example would be during the pandemic, I was working at Memorial Pathway Academy, and our students are newcomers. That means that they are new to the country. They have 0 to 3 years of English. And I will never forget that passing out Chromebooks, hotspots, reassuring families that it was going to be okay. Not only are you in a new country, but some of our students were here with family members. You know, it was very, very different for them. And so that sense of community during a time where we did not know what our next move was going to be solidified that I was in the right place. So I just truly believe that it is a very great place to be, but it's personal for me. It's personal because it is family. And I'm just the things that I've been through in the last couple of years, losing my own family to gun violence. I will never forget what Garland did for me to make sure that I was okay. Thank you.
Well, thank you.
So when we started planning for the read-in, myself and my principal, Principal Ariola, we met together, and for the read-in, his main focus really was community. And I was like, oh, this is so cool. This is awesome. The kids have been in and out of quarantine or, you know, at home virtually. And now we're all back here together and we're going to focus on community. Well, January came and then we moved to yellow. So it was like I kind of had to alter my mindset because I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, maybe I can't invite everyone in the community. But what I learned was that community was the people right here in my building, especially with me being new. There were so many people for me to meet and so many programs that I didn't know we had and so many clubs. So quickly, I learned that community was the people that I see in this building every day. I just had to step outside of my classroom, literally. I didn't even know we had a step team, and we had a step team perform. Someone was like, would you like the step team to come? And I'm like, we have a step team? And we do, and they're great. So MST, we have tons of MST students who are great, and they came and did all of our decorations for us and helped us set up tables. Health and science technology, they served the food for us. We just had our jazz band formed newly, and they played, and they were on the video, and I don't know if y'all got a chance to hear them, but listen, they are phenomenal. They're great. And so my lens kind of had to shift because when we talked about community, I'm like, okay, well, I can invite the NAACP and I can go knock on this door and knock on this door. But all I really had to do was knock on the doors of my neighbors. Everyone was so giving in this building. And there was so much going on that I wouldn't have known about as a new person. So I'm really blessed to be able to do that program because I've met just wonderful people, wonderful teachers, and teachers who give up their time daily with students, and amazing programs that they're running. And everyone was just so giving of their time and their resources. So I don't know if I necessarily thought about that when we were talking about community, but this is my community. It's my building. It's my campus. It's the people that I say good morning to when I walk through the door. The people who come by for a cup of coffee, that's my community. And I really, really internalized that better together spirit because let me tell y'all, it was a lot of work. And every time I see people throughout the day, all day today, I'm like, thank you, thank you, thank you. I wouldn't have been able to do it without you. Because it was so much to do, but everyone just took on their own task and came through and pulled together. And so I really have that better together spirit. I can't help but like give back to my neighbors now when they ask me for something. So it's been great.
And I know that community really exists across all of our schools, right? That teachers are giving. And so the students have a chance to perform, to grow their voice, to find their voice. And it's the adults in the building that are supporting that and inviting the parents and the families in to celebrate the growth and I've used the word growth twice now, but really that's what I'm hearing, that our children are exploring their voice, finding it, using it, you know, towards their own purpose and passion. And whether it's a musical voice or the written voice or the, you know, it's voice, right? It's speaking out and advocating for themselves, whether it's in English or in Spanish, right? We have 80 something or 100 something languages in our district. And so we're always helping students express themselves and grow in their ability to articulate their own goals and purpose and desires. And I think that the read-in was a beautiful example of that. And just, I appreciate hearing your passion for supporting the students. And honestly, what you described was a whole community, right? That was your word, coming together to support you and support the students that wanted to participate in this event. Ms. Davis, last but not least, how does celebrating all of our cultures, all of our diverse community, help foster the idea that we are better together?
Well, and I have to piggyback on you, Jonathan. I'm like you. I have an opportunity to go to all the schools in Garland, and never once have I felt unwelcome. Never once has anyone ever said, we don't want to talk about literacy. We don't want to talk about access and equity. Never. And I have truly been so blessed to be a part of this team and collaborating with the key stakeholders and Garland. I brag about it all the time. Garland was actually recently highlighted at our national sales conference because of the amazing work that's going on, the amazing equity work, the digital read-in and all the amazing things that are going on, you know, the read-ins on campus. And it's just like, I was getting chills listening to you guys talk because it is just truly a community. Like you said, I live just outside the community, but I still feel like I'm a part of it. And no one's ever turned a blind eye or any of that because of that. So, you know, I'm trying to raise two young men too. And so, you know, some of the things, the amazing stuff that I've seen and Garland, I bring back to them because, you know, I want them to understand, you know, there is life outside of your bubble. You know, there is life outside of this city and this city. There's amazing things going on everywhere. And, you know, I moved to North Texas for that reason, from Southeast Texas, not far from where Ms. Smith was. So, you know, it's just been an amazing opportunity. And I truly couldn't do this without us being better together, without the collaboration of the FACE team and, you know, Dr. Lopez's buy-in and this huge project of Literacy for Life and just making sure that all kids can read, all their parents can read. Not only is it going to benefit everyone, it's also going to benefit us economically. It's going to benefit us all. And so it's just been an honor to be a part of that and continue this process. You know, I look forward to the future challenges and contests that we're going to have and, you know, continuing to grow and learn through your teaching staff and through your students, because I have truly learned more as a professional. It doesn't matter how many degrees you have, how many years you've taught, it's always going to be a continuous learning experience. So I'm truly honored to be a part of that and a part of this amazing GISD team that supports this literacy and this effort.
All right, thank you. Here's the wild card question, right? This is your chance. What have we not discussed yet, but you feel it's really important for families to know?
So that's a heavy question. But, you know, I was sitting here thinking, how could our families truly plug in to GISD? And ironically, it's National School Counselors Appreciation Week. And I think our families should ensure that they have a direct line, a direct relationship with our counselors, with their child, their student's counselor. And that opens up so many doors just to ensure that they have that relationship. They know not only what's going on academically, but socially and sometimes emotionally with our students. And if you look at the trajectory from K through 12, the school counselor and most of the time at the secondary level, there's more than one, is a wealth of knowledge, a wealth of connections, and they embody what we've all been saying today, community. At the elementary level, they build a sense of community by not just dressing up for dress-up days, but instilling principles in students that are imperative, like buddy systems and honesty and just having teaching good guidance lessons. Middle school, we move more into a career focus. And then secondary is that graduation path, as well as their options, exploring what options they want for post-secondary. All throughout their K through 12 path, they are focused on some sort of reading as well as community. And so I just would, and just really instill in our parents to, if they haven't yet, to make that connection with their school counselors. I think that that will continue to open up doors for their students.
Well, I appreciate you saying that, because it is Counselor Appreciation Week, and it doesn't take a gift, right? It can take a note, a note of appreciation, a note of thanks. So if a counselor has spoken to your child, helped with test anxiety, helped with a skinned knee, helped with a four-year plan to graduate, helped with college applications, or you know, the whole wealth of knowledge that you're referring to. If a counselor has helped your child, then that's the counselor you need to thank. And this is a good week to do it. So anyone else want to chime in here? What is something that you feel we have not discussed, but it's important for families to know?
I'll just chime in a little bit. I think that it's important for families to know that your teacher, your principal, your counselor, and everyone right now is doing the absolute best that we can for your student. We are all doing the best that we absolutely can for your student. And I think that's important for students to know as well as parents. When we started this semester even, there was a few uncertainties about how things were going to go. And I had to talk with my students and I'm like, look, we don't know what's going to happen, but what I can assure you is that I am going to do the best that I can. And I just ask that you do the same. And I think that's reassuring for parents to know that, listen, we're doing the best that we absolutely can, no matter the circumstance or the uncertainties for your student. And I know that's reassuring for me here as even a parent. My student goes to North Garland High School, so I'm invested here. And I know the other teachers are too. And we don't always know how things are going to play out, but we're all going to do the best that we can.
All right. Thank you. Yes.
I was just going to add, you know, use this time to have conversations with your kids. I have really found a silver lining in the pandemic, and that is that it's given me time to truly stop and actually sit down and have a conversation with my family. My husband and my children, you know, sometimes we'll use my on news to spur that conversation. But in the end, you know, like I said, I have a chance to travel all over the country. And I just honestly, I just remind everybody, just stop and have those conversations. And I think us, the last few years have spurred some conversations that have been incredibly meaningful for our young adults and for our children and for our students that are giving them voice that they've never had or never thought about having. And so I just tell everybody, just don't forget that, you know, take that time. We spent too much time together. I think sometimes during the pandemic, I was like, give me space. But I think in the end, it was truly a blessing in disguise because I got to know my kids again. And now we have these conversations that we probably would have never had before. So just embrace this time, embrace Black History Month, embrace that to have these conversations and move forward and be grateful for the amazing life that we do have.
Wise words. I'm just struck by the things that you thought parents need to know. None of it had to do with African American History Month. Okay. And so, yes, this is an incredibly important topic, right? And yet, we're in the middle of a pandemic. We're in a social emotional crisis sometimes with our children. Our teachers are working overtime to give kids their best, right? And families, I'm just speaking directly to families now. Families, you matter to us. Your children matter to us. And if there's anything about African American History Month or anything else that these guests just said, this is really important. Reach out to us. We will connect you with counseling. We will connect you with GAPS. We will connect you with someone at your campus that can support you, that can give you the resources, that can help you with whatever it is that you're asking help with, right? We have an incredible counseling department. We have incredible counselors. We have incredible educators. And the one thing that drives all of us in this work is that we love your children. So thank you for being with us. Thank you for watching this. Thank you for sharing this. And please feel free to reach out to us. You can use askface@garlandisd.net. You can email us there. And with that, I just want to say thank you for joining us. And please remember to like us and share it. Thank you. Everyone have a good night.